Let's bring you into all of what we're doing. You know what it is. Come, let's play. Let's have some fun. On Twitter, we're channels underscore sports. And on Facebook, we're channels IFN Sports. To come up on your screen, that's what it is. You can also join the conversation with the hashtag African Games. We're still taking a look at the games taking place in Congo, Brazzaville. Let's talk about Nigerian football. This over-reliance on football in Nigeria. And that's why everyone is feeling so downcast that, oh my God, they didn't win. Super Falcons failed. Dream Team 6 failed. No, it's about time to start looking at ways to develop other sports. So let's join the hashtag, the discussion with the hashtag Nigerian football. And of course, the UEFA Champions League is back. And what a record for Cristiano Ronaldo. Career 79th UEFA Champions League goal.
Actually.
80. 80. And that trick last night. Mm-hmm. Wow. 80. And Ayotune loves that. He's smiling.
No, well, I definitely, I would love
John it. John will match
but, no, but everything can change by, you know, at the end of today. Don't forget, Lionel Messi of will course. Also have to go out there and prove his mettle against Roma. But I have a problem, you know, in the game of yesterday. Two penalties awarded.
Yeah.
For me, you know, in all honesty, I think those two were
soft.
Were very soft.
The first one, more
very soft.
The referee, you know, got it back.
You know,
very
got
bad.
It wrong.
Was his back.
The second one as well.
Yeah.
I mean, but hey,
it's UEFA Champions League.
It's Champions League. You're going for the 3 points. You know,
and then you're going against Real Madrid. But
I think
players.
really, you know, I think it takes us time to really appreciate players like Cristiano Ronaldo and Lionel Messi, what they've done for football, done for themselves and done for football. 5-6 years ago, you know, you probably think, yeah, nobody can, you know, upstage Raul
González.
You know, this is too much for any individual to do. And they're just playing with the records every day. The play, this one does it today, the next
it's
day.
It's a motivation, you know. You achieve one today, I'll achieve two.
I'm just
the
thinking,
next day, you know.
And this guy, it looks like this guy's,
chase.
These guys will be around for the next 4 or 5 years, and they're going to push and keep pushing the barriers. So it's going to be very hard to see another person come up and beat these guys.
Cristiano Ronaldo is still what I used to know of him 4 seasons ago.
Yeah.
Messi is still what I used to know of him 5, even 6 seasons
ago. If not better.
If not better. You know, the older they get, they just keep getting better, improving on their game.
And like you said, I think the competition, you know, knowing that you have to beat this
the
guy
other person
to be the
to
best.
Achieve success.
You know,
that's the motivation.
Yeah.
That's what drives
them.
Interesting. All right, let's look at the Africa Games now going on in Brazzaville, Congo. Like I did say when we started the show, that Team Nigeria, talking about athletics, the medals are piling in. They're coming in thick and fast. There you have it on the screen now from the slide presentation. Team Nigeria wins 3 gold medals. Interesting one, guys, in athletics in day 3 at the ongoing 2015 Africa Games in Brazzaville. And of course, our dear Blessing Okagbare doing what she knows how to do best. Helping Nigeria to win gold in the women's 4x100
meters. Let me quickly talk about that one quickly. I'm very happy she joined up with the team. I'm very happy we beat the Ivorians. Mm-hmm. Let's not forget the Ivorians won the gold for the men and for the women. And at that point, they were a threat to Nigeria. Mm. And Blessing came on. She was part of the quartet.
Yes. I think she took the second lap.
She took the second lap.
And she was outstanding.
Loretta Ozor, Ngozi
Oumere, and
Cecilia
Francis.
And it was good. A victory over the Ivorians. But the lesson we have learned is that they are now showing us that they are a force to be reckoned with. We also took a couple of medals from sports. I'm very sure still we'll talk about that, from sports where you think is not our, you know,
stronghold.
This
one, interesting. Oluwatobiloba Amojong stormed the victory, yes, in the 100 meters hurdles, clocking 13.15 seconds.
Yeah.
You know, adding to the gold tally. The interesting one for me was the javelin event. Nigeria winning the second field event in gold. That's through Kelechi Nwanega. Austin, you were saying something about her.
That's what it is.
Before coming into the studio.
I'd like the director to just let the viewers see some visuals of that's true. It was a second attempt, and Kelechi Nwanega, I was actually a former member of the Super
of
Falcons.
The Super Falcons.
She was a footballer.
For many who don't know.
Yeah, and then checked it and said, that's right there on your screen. Kelechi Nwanega, a second attempt, actually. And then she promised us gold before leaving for Congo Brazzaville. You know, and for her, she says that we've done so well in the tracks. Now, let people start talking about us in the field events. And that's the true right there, about 50.75 meters, which is really good for her. And she got the gold the gold medal in a javelin, and it was really good. She went to the coach. Coach told her, "Well done,
beating,
that's good enough to win it."
Ghana's Mary Zuta, and of course,
the good thing about this and the lesson for me is that you know, in life, you have to put your best foot forward. Chioma Adjoa too was a footballer before she Usain Bolt could do long jump, they decided, look,
in
fact,
Usain Bolt says if he has the opportunity, he will go back to football and after athletics.
Carl Lewis, for instance, when he saw that the young boys were catching up, switched, went to long jump. And I'm very happy, you know, when you know the right foot to place forward and, you know, put you into prominence. I'm very happy.
That's it.
And Austin, before we came on, we were talking about, you know, I argued with you, but I think I'm beginning to have a rethink. when you said, even in the height of our powers, I think we left
the field events
to others.
Yeah.
It was just basically tracks.
Yeah, and the South Africans, even now Kenya, you need to see, Nigeria is not interested. They just want to do the relays, they want to do the sprints, do the tournament.
They're shifting their focus.
Okay, let's see. There's a lot to win in javelin, there's a lot to win in discus, there's a lot to win in the field.
And even in your area of stronghold, they are venturing into it.
Now, see the way we lost the 4x100 meters relay men. Lost it at the 50 meters mark towards the end. We had the lead, and then the Ivorians just came. And I took it away from Nigeria.
What's wrong with our male
That's
athletes?
A lot. We have said that Solomon Ogba will come back for part two of that interview. We need to understand the role of Maurice Greene. Guys, remember he was employed for the relays. You know, and we're not seeing that sort of, you know, improvement that we wanted from our team, particularly the men. The men, I mean, they've been struggling for almost 6 years now.
And you know, when you're talking about medal prospects, we don't talk about them because we don't want to get our hearts broken. We usually talk about the women. And the women, in all fairness, have done us well. Mm. And we must also commend Blessing Okagbare because from the reports and from the clips, you know, the effect of the second leg, the Ivorians just didn't recover.
That was
recover.
What wanted for Nigeria.
Just couldn't.
That exactly okay, that's look, it. At it, look at the gap
just
right
she,
there.
She built that gap and the Ivorians just couldn't, even though they had two of their stars there, just couldn't cope. And I'm happy with what we've
Cecilia achieved. Francis, she had a very good start under the baton over to Blessing Okagbare. Yeah. She gave it to Ingozu Owumere, and then Loretta also. She didn't look back. It was a sprint down there. Look at it. Sheer determination. Nobody could come close, not even the Ghanaians or the Ivorians.
She was racing against the records. There was nothing. Yeah. She didn't think of anybody behind her because they were nowhere close.
43.10 seconds. Not really bad for Team Nigeria. Still continues their dominance in the 4x100 meters. Remember,
the
defending
champions. And it's also the second fastest time since the Miriam Yalila team ran 43.04 seconds. That was in 2003.
Let me also throw this one in quickly because, you know, we get accused of not really talking about Yakubu Adesokan.
Oh, my goodness.
Set a new world record.
Yeah.
I mean, what a way in powerlifting event. And, you know, that's, I'm sure that's one of the areas the DG was making reference to, areas where we're going to, and, you know, what a way to start it off for Nigeria, setting a new record with, it lifted 182.5 kilograms to win gold.
Yeah, that's what it is.
That's remarkable, remarkable for a Nigerian. And I just hope that we're able to pick more medals.
And what you don't have on your screen is that Tijani Latifat also followed the footsteps of Yakubu to also win a gold medal in the women's 98 kg lift. She was fantastic. Our special athletes keep doing good things. It means it's time to start looking at ways to support them.
And put a structure, put a structure to this. All of those events that, you know, athletes with physical challenges, you can always trust that if we put a structure to it, definitely
they will do well.
So that's it. New world record for Yakubu Adesokan. He has always been consistent. Commonwealth gold medalist, Olympics gold medalist. It's about time. I think he was also awarded in the last administration
for
all he has done for sports in the country, and it's really, really uplifting. Guys, we spoke to the president of the Nigerian Table Tennis Federation yesterday. He was confident, but he also let us realize that it is very competitive in table tennis. And we saw it yesterday in the mixed doubles. Congo, unseeded Congo Brazzaville, defeated Nigeria's pair of Olufunke Oshanaike and Ojo Onolapo. 3-0. Shocking. Shocking, but that's what it is.
That's what it is.
That's what we said, that Nobody's coming there to look at, oh, they are Nigerians. If you don't prepare, they're not ready.
In table tennis, the margin of defeat can be very,
very slim. He said it. Yeah. I mean, he said it. The president said it.
The fact that it's slim doesn't mean anything. It's defeat all the same. but it just shows that probably there was some elements.
You need to lose in three sets to an unseeded Congo. You know, that's what I was saying when we got back from Yaoundé. I was telling the players. Now, I spoke to some of the Congolese and the Cameroonians. They said, we don't want to look at Egypt. Nigeria can beat Egypt, so we need to beat Nigeria. You get what I'm saying? So it's not about, you say, oh, I used to be a powerhouse, I used to do so well. So when these people see me, they're just going to, no, nobody will feel like everybody is working so hard. So guys, after yesterday, it's now 25 gold medals for Team Nigeria. So we're still chasing 25 gold medals, 33 silver and 25 bronze, a total of 83 medals.
Okay, let me put you on the spot now with 3 days to go. Can we eat that 35 gold medal mark?
We could. It's 25 now. We could in wrestling.
At least from what the DG NSC said, you know, 25 projection. Said between projection, and they've gotten it, so they can do get better. We can get it in
so we can get 10.
Yeah, we can get in
we
wrestling.
We still get a sprinkle from powerlifting.
Of course, a lot of events still going on in powerlifting. Table tennis, singles, doubles, we can still get something.
Basketball.
Just to let our viewers know that
we're in the semifinals.
And the D-Tigers as well.
So it's looking good, but in all, still some lessons that we need to come back and then try, because I put a call across to the president of the Fencing Federation. And I said, President, you were on this show, and then you said something. That's our semifinal fixture.
Men.
Nigeria taking on Egypt. And the Tigers captain, Olumide Oyedeji, says there's no way Egypt.
No cause for alarm. They are the African champions. Well, come on.
Their last game was 102 to 23 points victory for 4 Nigeria. For the ladies, I'm a bit scared. And you know, okay, that's the...
For the women.
The results that took us... To the semi-final. We defeated Gabon, you know, talking to our customers these days.
Yeah.
Defeated
them. Look at that.
Angola.
Look at that.
Yeah, it was slim.
Against Mali was 1 point. Mm-hmm. Against Gabon now, 1 point. But the good thing is, it means they're showing character to be able to hold on to win when it's a crucial 1 point that is needed to win. Mm-hmm. But guys, I was just trying to understand how we can get to 38 gold medals.
He said 35. You already said
35.
We can get 35.
Let's make it 40.
That's what it is.
40.
Come on, Yemi, you can say 45.
Okay.
No.
But what I'm saying is, did you mention that we could have gotten 15 medals from fencing? And we like the sort of enthusiasm that the president, Adeyinka Samuel, brought when he visited us to talk about fencing in Nigeria. We like the fact that we're looking at different ways. But the DG, surprisingly, said to us that he didn't even know there was a fencing federation in Nigeria.
That's too bad.
So I spoke to the president and I said, hey, you need to come tell Nigerians what's going on. We need to know because the team prepared, released a list.
11-man team
list. And for the DG not to even have an idea that such
something,
federation
exists. That's exactly what you use. Something went wrong somewhere. And as journalists, you know, it's our duty here to ensure that you hear both sides of the story.
That's what it is.
So it's easy for us to conclude and say, how come we know and Mr.
Know.
DG, you don't know? It's easy to say that way. But of course, if the president of the Fencing Federation comes, what exactly did you do? And what did you not do?
Yeah.
You know, tell us what you did, and we'll look at what you did not do.
A secretariat at the NSC. You know,
I think that is where the problem.
Or was it that they were hoping to get crash? You know, that you know, we'll
definitely
where the guy
thrash
when
it
comes.
When he comes.
Yeah,
we will definitely thrash that out when he comes.